Hello and welcome to PowerDrift. This is Simplified, where we take complicated ideas and break them down into small bite-sized pieces that you can use in your life with motorcycles. And today we're talking about anti-lock braking systems, or ABS. Before we go ahead, I invite you to do the little things for us. Subscribe, bell notification icon, like, and if you love this video, please do also show it to your friends. I think it might be useful. So, anti-lock braking systems. What the system do is technically in its name, anti-lock braking system, and lock refers to a wheel that's no longer rotating. Why is that a problem? As long as your wheel is rotating, the biggest thing that you gain from it is the ability to control what that wheel is doing in terms of if you hit the brakes, if you hit the accelerator or turn the wheel, that wheel is able to react to your input and produce a predictable result. Once the wheel locks up, once you're skidding, it's very, very difficult to exert any kind of reasonable control on this tire, and that's what anti-lock braking systems prevent. So let's bust the first myth. Anti-lock braking systems do not always reduce the stopping distance. That is a positive side effect in most conditions, but it's not true for all conditions. So if you were to have a bike with ABS on gravel or on ice or on snow, chances are your stopping distances will be longer with ABS than without. And the reason is, for example, some of these surfaces will form a little bit of a wedge in front of the tire, and the wedge produces a much stronger retardation force than a rolling tire with ABS active. Right? How does this system work? In most cases, the ABS system's work starts with sensors on the wheels that report to the computer, the ABS computer, what the state of the wheels are in terms of rotation. Many ABS systems are able to use just one tire. So for example, if I have a single channel ABS system, which means it only works on one wheel, usually the front wheel, the system can monitor if the front wheel is rotating or not and calculate whether there is an acceleration going on or a deceleration going on. Sometimes, some systems use both the wheels and compare wheel speeds with each other, which is why you have a single channel ABS system which operates only on the front brake, but you'll see the slotted rings on both the wheels. The slotted wheel essentially is a little metal ring that sits on your hub, and basically there's a small magnet placed very close to it, and the magnet is reading the arrival and passing of the spokes of the slots. When a spoke comes close, you get a spike in the magnetic force. When the gap comes close, you get a depression in the magnetic force. And the difference in this amplitude is what is used to calculate how fast the wheel is rotating. This is why they say that if you're going to make a drastic change in the size of your tire, you might upset the calibration of the ABS and traction control systems, because both of them rely on that slotted ring and the known circumference of the tire to tell the system how fast the wheel is rotating. The system actually starts to work only once it detects an unusual amount of deceleration or a wheel speed that is approaching zero. In both the situations, the computer recognizes that there is a hazard coming and it needs to do something. To do this something, what the ABS system adds to a normal hydraulic disc brake system is a set of valves. Now, these valves are essentially three positions and a small overflow circuit. And what they basically do is they control the pressure in the system no matter what you're doing with the lever to ensure that the wheel continues to rotate. Let's take the example of a simple hydraulic system, a non-ABS motorcycle, for example, right? When you hit the lever, what you're effectively doing is building pressure in the hydraulic circuit, which causes the pads to come against the disc and press hard on it. If I keep doing this, eventually the wheel speed will become zero. When the wheel speed is zero, but the vehicle speed is non-zero, you have a skid, right? What an ABS system adds to this is the set of valves that I spoke about, and what happens when this wheel speed approaches zero but the vehicle speed is not zero is that a valve opens, and now you get an overflow circuit, which is effectively like a longer pipe. Because the hydraulic fluid now has more space, it reduces the pressure in the system, which means that the pads, which are pressing against your disc, remember, they open up a little bit and the wheel can start rotating again. As soon as the wheel starts to rotate again, the system can start reapplying pressure and trying to slow the wheel down further. And again, just before the wheel locks, the pressure will release again. And this pressure being built up and built down by the valve is what you feel as pulsing on the lever. It's also what stops the wheel from rotating entirely. That's basically what an anti-lock braking system does. You can add more electronics and intelligence to this. So if you have cornering ABS, for example, then this system's computer is able to gain data about the lean angle of the motorcycle and make further calculations as to how much pressure needs to be released and at what point the pressure intervention needs to actually happen. And pressure intervention is one of the reasons why you love some ABS systems and you'll hate other ABS systems. A lot of work goes into calibrating how an ABS system will come alive and how will it function. All right. So there are two or three things that go into this. One is how fast can the system cycle. So if you have a 10 hertz ABS system, it means it can intervene 10 times a second, which is pretty quick. But faster systems can hit 50 hertz or even 100 hertz, which means the system is able to recognize a problem 100 times a second and intervene if it needs to. So you almost never feel the fact that you approach lockup, And more importantly, the pulsing in your lever is so small that you may not feel it as anything more than a slight vibration. Whereas if I were to give you a system with 5 or 10 hertz, because it's vibrating at a much, much lower frequency, you will feel it as an actual pulsing of the lever. So if you look at older ABS systems, the pulsing was very strong. Modern ABS systems don't really pulse the lever a lot. You'll feel it as a vibration. The next thing that can happen if you're using an ABS system and braking really hard is that your rear wheel can start lifting off as the motorcycle pivots around the front axle because of the forces involved. Advanced ABS systems are able to recognize that this event is about to occur to prevent the front axle from becoming a pivot point around which the motorcycle rotates into what is called a stoppie. This is officially called lift-off control or rear lift mitigation, depends on the manufacturer, but a racer, for example, will switch into race ABS, and one of the first things race ABS does is switch off the control over when the motorcycle starts to lift should we reduce the pressure on the front brake. This is because a racer is presumed to have a lot of skill, and once the rear wheel is 2, 3, 4 inches off the ground, he can continue to operate the motorcycle because this event, which is a very, very extreme event in terms of what forces are in play and how you generate it, but this extreme event is something that a racer is prepared for, and he doesn't need intervention from the ABS at that point. So a race ABS motorcycle will still unlock the front wheel if it locks up. But if the rear wheel starts to lift, it will not intervene, assuming that the human in charge has the controls and he knows what he's doing. In a sense, that is how ABS systems work. On motorcycles in India, because of the way the rule was created, we do have single channel ABS systems. They only work on the front wheel. We do have a simplified episode on how braking works and how you should use your brakes, which explains why the front wheel is the most critical braking part of your motorcycle. It's not the rear wheel, which is why single channel ABS systems tend to go to the front wheel. You also have dual channel systems which operate on the front and the rear wheel, and 99% of the time they operate independently of each other, which means the rear ABS being activated has no effect on the front wheel, front ABS being activated has no effect on the rear wheel. The biggest connection you'll get is if there is rear liftoff mitigation, in which case if the rear wheel comes off the ground and the system senses it, it will release pressure in the front even if the front wheel is nowhere close to lockup. But the thing you need to understand about fundamental difference between car ABS and motorcycle ABS is that on a car, it's designed for an idiot who's driving. I was at an Audi training school where the ABS test was very, very simple. The instructor says, I want to see your knee when I'm standing outside the driver's door. That's how high you will lift your foot, and you'll hit that pedal with everything you've got, and then the ABS system in the car will do all of the work. On a motorcycle, if you were to do the exact same thing, which is grab the lever like this, is that the brakes will come on strong and lock up the wheel very, very early on before the weight transfer can generate more grip. And that's why on a motorcycle, using ABS does require a little bit more skill. Honestly, it is a negative in terms of how much work you have to put in to get ABS to do the maximum possible job for you. But to me, motorcycles are about skilled people doing skilled things, and to me, this is exactly how it's supposed to be. So braking on motorcycles, it's not the simplest thing in the world. Using ABS at maximum efficiency on a motorcycle is not also the simplest thing in the world, but the whole pleasure of motorcycling is that we get to learn new things every day. The final thing I would submit is that a lot of people are worried that electronic interventions like ABS can destroy your experience of motorcycling, and I would say that's just not true. ABS, traction control, all of these systems only appear on the scene as visible partners in crime when you've reached the limit of something, and if something is not done to prevent what happens next, you will get hurt or your motorcycle will be broken or both. So if you ride an ABS motorcycle normally and have an uneventful ride, you will not be aware that ABS is working. But if you were riding the motorcycle normally and hit a patch of sand, you're on the brakes, ABS will allow you to get through the patch of sand without having a crash. Without ABS, you would have a crash. The last thing, professional riders under controlled conditions like near perfect weather, clean roads, great tires, in those conditions can sometimes outperform ABS. And that's a big statement to make because it's sometimes outperform, which means for most of us, ABS will help us a lot more than get in our way. Thank you so much for watching. This is Simplified. We take complicated automotive ideas, break them down into small pieces that you can use in your motorcycle life. If you'd like to discuss braking and ABS in more detail, all you have to do is leave us a comment. If you'd like any other topic, just leave us a comment. We'll get right on it. Thank you so much for watching. Please do hit subscribe and the bell notification icon. If you loved this video, hit the like button. And please do show this to your friends. I think they will find it useful.